There we go. Look at us go. Now we are live. And we can actually start playing this game. Slightly new location on account of we rearranged the studio. So let me shuffle into view here. We rearranged the studio. So now I'm on the other side. Camera, camera, camera. I'm here. I believe in you. Still playing around with the lighting. We got new lights. And eventually there's going to be stuff on that wall, but right now it's just putty to fill in the bits. But super excited. I haven't actually put up the mod list because I'm a bad person. And because I've been super busy prepping for Maker Expo, which is coming up on September 10th. We're going to be doing an 8-hour podcast. Also, I launched a new website, so you can go to wusuriot.com and see old videos from the channel. So collaborations, Minecraft videos, podcasts, music, etc. So far, I don't have all of them up yet, but there's some other stuff there too. The drink of tonight is Pepsi because I enjoy being fat. All right, let's start with our spreadsheets. So, when last we left our heroes... Hey, Rich, how's it going? We had unlocked a bunch of new people. So we unlocked Helen, we unlocked Pavel, and we were Elena, the fortress. We'd just come to Morthal. We solved a mystery about a dude who burned his house down, only it turns out it wasn't him who burned his house down. It was vampires, and we were trying to put the ghost of his daughter to rest. And we did so by exposing the vampire conspiracy to the Jarl. And that was where Elena left off. She's the Thane of Whiterun. She fights with fire spells. So when we now that we return, it's vampires. So let's hop over to our Skyrim screen here. Just get a little more space. And now we are Pavel, because Pavel is a vampire hunter. Also, I rearranged my entire system, so if anybody can let me know what my audio balance is like, that would be awesome. So, kill the master vampire. Can do. Pavel, of course, fights with two weapons. And his weapon of choice is throwing weapons, and I don't actually have any. So we're back in the realm of not having... No, it turns out he didn't burn it down. Laylette burned it down. Who she was also the thrall of a vampire. Or she was a vampire herself. But that much we uncovered from Alva's journal, which we read. Now we're on our way to kill Movarth. I almost blanked on his name. Who's the lord of these vampires. He's an ancient vampire. And a whole bunch of townsfolk got there ahead of us. Courageous townsfolk.
Oh, this place looks dangerous.
Yeah, kind of scary, too.
You're gonna...
full of vampires?
You guys wanna...
Cowards, we must kill the vampires.
Yeah, definitely.
Of course. But why not let him go in first?
Well, for one, I'm not really wearing pants. Or a shirt. Thanks, Rich. Yeah, I've still been messing with it. Yeah, we took the whole computer system apart, which is elaborate. I've still got to troubleshoot some audio stuff. It may have dropped one of my speakers, which is not super great, but they're also not super great speakers, so I'm not broken hearted about it. But... yeah, it's a whole thing. Alright. Oh, right. I forgot about the buffs. So I don't actually know what our buffs are right now. But we should find out. Alright, come on, spider. Fight you. The game graphics need an upgrade, which is funny because I don't see him streaming anything. So, see what we've got for buffs right now. We have Divine Armor and Earthbound Weapon. Yeah, sure, we'll keep these up. Gotta stay warm, not wearing a shirt. So, this is the only set of light armor I had. And I haven't had a chance to do a bonus stream. I might do it Thursday night if I'm feeling super ambitious, because I really need to do something about this inventory. But I also might have to go and help clean and arrange a second grade classroom, which I like you and everything, but it's going to be super rad. Alright, so we got Alteration 25. That means we can join the Mages Guild now, though, with their College of Winterhold. So, just around this corner is Movarth. I'm just gonna sort of take a sit here, take a breather. Now, there's like four vampires over there. Vampires are awful. They're resistant to cold, they're resistant to like a lot of spells that affect living things. Yeah, I guess the other question is, how's the brightness? Because we're in a dark cave, so if somebody could tell me how the brightness is, that would be rad. But, no, vampires are awful. They drain your health. So, we're going to put on our Cloak of Magic Resistance to keep us warm. Yeah, we have fur armor. No, we're not wearing it. There we are. It'll keep us warm. And it'll make us a little more resistant to magic. We do need a torch or a light spell. I'm actually just going to bump the brightness a bit. What do we do for the Minecraft videos? We max out the brightness. There, that's maybe a little better, but you're right. I probably need a light spell. Let's see what we can do. Ha! Found you! Movarth clean. Alright, let's get him. Uh-oh. Situation not great. Also, I just contracted the vampire virus. Oh, can't turn invisible. I see through your invisibility. Offhand axe for the win there. God, this is why I love the Swamp Knight. Goodbye. The Swamp Knight, she's got feedback for everything. She's gonna be our best friend for a long time, I think. Oh, I didn't. Let me quickly go and say. So I'm using Sky UI. I'm using the top hotkeys, which are my function keys. And this lets me save multiple pieces of gear. Yeah, no kidding. We might bring a candlelight spell into our rotation if we've got one. If not, we'll pick one up when we get to town. We could probably buy one back in Morthal. But, yeah, Sky UI. I live or die by Sky UI. God, this improved the game so much for me. And I can group things together, so I want to be a two-weapon fighter. Well, that's cool. I just put two weapons on this hotkey. It doesn't always work. Sometimes with weapons from mods, it'll mess up. Scroll of Pull from Eternity. Cast on a corpse to store its ghost. And cast on a target to summon the ghost to attack the target for 40 seconds. The ghost takes less damage from attacks. Weird. That's a good point. I might get the Belt Lantern mod. I hadn't thought about it before, but if we're going to be streaming, we need to be able to see. I might dig through that off stream. So we're going to deal for today. But like I said, when I get back to Morthal, which will be soon because I just killed the Master Vampire, like a boss. Got his armor. Vampire armor of minor conjuration. So we could wear vampire armor, but as a vampire hunter, it's a little at odds. Also, we super need to get to a shrine because we contracted sanguinaria vampirus, which means we're going to turn into a vampire if we're not careful. And nobody wants me to be a vamp. Alba! I had something that I meant to tell you. Oh, it was, I'm glad you're dead, you piece of garbage. Thank you for your objects. Oh! Excuse me. Oh! Swamp Knight got that one. Alright. And Movarth, motherfucker, loves shoes. I think the shoes are there, I just grabbed Movarth's boots. And Movarth's boots are enchanted with sneakiness. And I think they're there to sort of cover up the notion that there's magic boots over here. We, of course, are stealing all those shoes and his midnight reading. Because fuck that guy. Preying on innocent townsfolk, responsible for the death of a child. You know what? No. He doesn't get to walk away from any of that. And now we're going to go this way to get out of the cave. Right? There's a bunch of different ways. All roads lead out, but this road leads to one more vampire. Oh! Oh! Ho, ho. Get that axe to the head. How are we doing need-wise? We're a little thirsty, but otherwise we're okay. Get some arrows. Let's get some coins. I can't pick up that skull. I need skulls for some crafting stuff. Yeah, vampires... It's interesting that there are no, like, cool romantic vampires in... Skyrim, they're all like total monsters. There's Serana from Dawnguard, and we're gonna meet her much later. But apart from that, there's no cool vampires. Mother's What's up, Helgi?
It's time for me to sleep now.
Aww.
I'm so tired.
Rest in peace. It's funny, sometimes you see Alba down here and she's not hostile to you. Which is really unfortunate for her because it means I just get the drop on her. Harkon is not a nice guy. To be fair, I've never taken Harkon's deal because I have no interest in being a vampire. Good job, everybody. Everybody stay strong, be cool. Glad we had this meeting. Goodbye. Yep. That was vampire. Yeah, we really need to do that bonus stream. We just need to outfit everybody. It'll be a good time. It'll be a weird time. I don't know, I played with spreadsheets and everybody seemed to like that, so... I officially can say that I'm not at all in touch with what is fun. Let's go crash at the inn. Because we didn't bring any camping supplies. I think we've got some firewood, but that's about it.
Fine. Pick up your boots, stay a while. Let me know if there's anything I can help with.
Oh my god, bartender, thank you. These days. Hate that when that bit when you walk up to the counter and they're not far away, or they're too far away.
Are you joking? You just rented a room for me.
Oh, I already have a room. Sweet. Even better. Let's get some sleep. Harkon and your Minecraft wizard would get along. That's half the reason we have a problem. All right. We're hungry and thirsty, so let's see what we can do about that. Let's eat a carrot. Mmm. And a salmon steak. And now we're full. So we're going to talk to Falion. And see if we can buy a candlelight spell and throw that in our rotation. Just so it means that, at the very least, and I'll also put it on our hotkey. But it means that during fights, we'll have light.
Some advice, friend. That armor won't offer.
That armor won't offer. Listen, I killed a master vampire while not wearing a shirt. I will not have you tell me what I need to wear a shirt for.
If you stand before me to accuse me of sacrificing children or eating the hearts of the dead, you may save your breath. I have done no such thing, nor do I intend to.
Falion is full of shit, but not in that way that we're going to murder him. He's a wizard. He moved to Morthal because it's way out in the sticks. And Nords don't like magic because they're classic medieval white people. So they don't like magic.
I keep to myself.
But he's also a really good conjuration trainer.
I seek only to
now the thing is he's like, I don't sacrifice children, I don't do blood magic, I don't do anything like that. But if I check what he's got for sale...
You figured for a mage. I think you'll appreciate this.
One of the things he sells is black soul gems, which are the only thing you can use to trap a human soul. So while he doesn't traffic in sacrifice, he could trap the soul of living creatures. Not just living creatures, but sentient creatures. Anyway, let's buy a scroll or a book of candlelight. I don't think there's anything else we need, so we'll be fine with that. So let's read our books. Deathly Paul, that's good. Spectral Missiles, Winter Woe for ice magic. Candlelight. And then we'll go and use Akato's Recital and Candlelight. And now we have Candlelight stored. So whenever we start a fight, our two buff spells and our light spell will go on.
Disrespect the law and you disrespect me.
Listen, guard. We cool. Now, there isn't... Oh, we have to talk to the Jarl still. Right. We didn't actually tell anybody we killed the Master Vampire.
Are you feeling sick?
Excuse me. Oh my god, you're twinsies! Oh no, one of you has a beard.
Good morning.
You, dude, we're gonna talk to you during the bonus stream.
You're different, aren't you? Not like anyone else.
I am different.
Or Skyrim.
Just a little.
Look at you. If only
I have cool tattoos.
You are trouble.
Missing an eye. And I have a big blood stain on my left side.
Tamriel is full of wisdom and magic. Yes.
I killed a vampire.
Now maybe we can take this as a token of our gratitude.
Money! Now, we can do some stuff for Idgrod, but we're not gonna. We're gonna come back as Elena and talk to her about what we can do for her town and for her.
I do what I can to see that Idgrud's time isn't wasted.
So, she only... killing a vampire actually only took us like 10 minutes. So what else are we gonna do? Well, we can do a whole bunch of things. We have lots of individual quests.
To deal with important
I matters. Think we're gonna head north. Intriguing. What? Hrogar went berserk and tried to attack the town. Now, you remember Hrogar from last time? Oh, you are right. I do need to get my disease cured. Let's talk to the apothecary and see if she has a potion of cure disease. That'll be the easiest way to do it. Chad keeping me honest. Keeping me disease free. Where is the apothecary? What time is it? It's lunchtime. Let's wait here for an hour. There she is. Hello.
You see those warriors? So you're interested in my potions and ingredients.
Specifically your potions, and specifically a potion of cure disease. Let's drink this right up. Yeah, we really need to clear out these potions too.
Oh, wow.
No more vampirism. Lots of other things, but no more vampirism. Yay!
That was just sitting there? I wish I found it first.
What do you mean, that was just sitting here? I just bought this from your grandma! I'm pretty sure she's his grandma. Who are you?
How can I help Garka. You?
Oh, you're from the inn.
I've been looking for you.
What?
I've got a letter. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
I got an inheritance letter? Cool. So when people die in Skyrim, sometimes you'll inherit things from them. I just don't know who died. Let's find out together. We made it into Hrogar's will? Wow, I bossed that guy hard. Whew. Well, Hrogar, you are a vampire's thrall and also a piece of human garbage, but thank you for the 90 bucks. That does in no way redeem you, and I will still stop to spit on your corpse and leave you naked in the streets. You can keep the key to Alva's house, though. Alright. So let's head north. This is a couple of interesting stuff. We're actually going to talk to that guy first. Lydia? Some firewood I can have. Yeah, I just need the one piece.
I'm just a poor man. What do you want, material?
He's not the guy for it. Well, maybe it's this guy. Yeah, it's this guy.
Honest gold for honest work.
Sell my firewood to him. Make some money. Now, there's all kinds of stuff up north of Morthal. Oh! We almost made it. We were so close. Yeah, that is the only downside, as I mentioned before, of modded Skyrim. Is. What you get is the occasional crash. It looks like we're just loading back in. There we are. Don't mind me, I'm just shutting my Steam chat off. I always forget to do that. So we should have a save from when we left the apothecary. Not downloading a mod and installing it during the stream. There's a million reasons why I'm not going to do that. We don't introduce new variables while we're live. Bad practice.
I've been looking for you.
Alright, so we're gonna inherit And we know that this is Hrogar's now.
Got to go.
My mother and father.
We're gonna desecrate Hrogar's body. Spit on him one more time. See in chat people addressing the reasons why I'm not downloading a mod in the middle of the stream. Like I said, there's a million of them, so it might take you a little while, but I appreciate that, and I imagine that by tomorrow morning you'll have all of them figured out. And that way, we'll be in a position to download something on the stream. Of course, the stream will be over by then, but don't worry too much about that. Yeah, no, I work in software. We don't do anything live. Elk! And remember, we still don't have any ranged attacks. That is a thing that concerns me a little bit. Oh, we need to stay away from that house. I'm pretty sure we need to stay. This might actually not be a good idea. There's a mod that adds a house into the swamps north of Morthal, which is where we are right now. But I'm pretty sure it comes with a dragon fight. And we can't fight a dragon right now. We are not... Well, I mean, we fought one, and we could hypothetically, but... We fought one where we had good, strong cover. Fighting a dragon without cover? That's a bad time. Like, that's... We're asking for trouble. So, we're gonna... Cut up, but we're gonna cut up across here, and we're gonna discover this for Janet later, because this is Ustengrav, which is where we need to go to get the. See, now we've got our lights. Wow. I'm actually going to turn the brightness down. It looks fine on stream, but for me it's just super bright, so. That'll do it. Yeah, I will probably fight a dragon tonight. But I am sort of hoping that I don't. Only because we're probably gonna die. Yeah, we really need to deal with all of our... crap. We might even do that tonight, but I kind of have some other plans, so... We'll see. The other place we're gonna go is Winstad Mine. Winstad Mine is awesome. And step one of making it awesome is walking through this door and kicking a bunch of ass. Wizard. Yeah, so this is an old mine. And if we can clear it out, and buy the deed, we can turn it into our mine, and we'll own it. Eventually, you can hire workers and build buildings, and we'll make money. Oh. also bumping our one-handed skill. Who's that bandit leader's journal? Helps keep the mind organized. So this is all fan-made. This is for a mod. So somebody wrote this whole book. So they're in here, digging through the mine, laying low. They don't have a good feeling about it, though, which is good. Because I'm here now. I am going to kill everyone that lives here. Life's going to get unfortunate. Those people don't live in squalor. They actually live pretty good lives. I mean, I build them houses and stuff, so... hiring a mine and getting rich while people live in squalor is the suggestion from chat. And we'll notice that that is exactly what people do in real life. This is a fantasy world, so people get treated better. Oh, wrong place, wrong time there. Do-do-do-do-do. You left. Well, you didn't even have time to get the right. Lydia! Lydia, come take my things! Lydia. She's sworn to bear my burdens, or something like that. So much stuff. Alright. So we have now cleared out the mine. And during bonus stream, we're probably gonna buy it. One of my companions always carries my stuff. There is a mode where you can, in convenient horses, where you can keep it on your horse. But I actually find it really inconvenient because my horse can't go indoors. And indoors is typically where I need lots of stuff. Or you can get it so you can access the horse inventory from anywhere. But that makes it a little too convenient. So I'm not necessarily a fan. But this will be Winstead Mine, and eventually we'll build a huge mining operation here. And then up on the hill... just up here... will be Winstead Manor. Because we can also buy this lot of land. Ooh. What have we got here? Spiders! This would be the perfect time for a, you know, throwing weapon. Fortunately, we don't have any. Alright, so we're going to cut across, because there's another dungeon I want to try and go do. Don't remember what this is, so... oh, this is the abandoned shack. Right. And the trick up here is getting through all this without freezing to death. Because if we get wet, we are done for. That cave over there is where we're bound. So this is the abandoned shack. And this will be part of the Dark Brotherhood quests we do later. I'm just gonna get it on our map. Okay, now we have to cross this without getting wet. So we're gonna Mario hop. Now we can go in the shallows, but... Oh, we got more spiders, it looks like. Just gonna tap my save there. This has been a while. Oh, poisoned. Oh. That dog is my pet? Used to me, I didn't have a pet. And this, I believe, is Corvinund? I can never keep track of which one it is, but if we don't come from the top, we're gonna have a problem. Fulgenthor. Catch this butterfly. There's a camp over here. Which appears to be... Oh, there's a journal. Alright. So this is like the beginning of the Galdr legend. Three brothers sealed away... Untold magical power, that kind of thing, you know. So let's hop in here. We're gonna get us some of that untold magical power. Or we're gonna die. A bunch. It's pretty hard to say which. But we're pretty good at this game, so we're probably gonna be fine. Okay, watch the noise. That is definitely 100% a pressure plate. Yep. And people have already been coming through here. So let's keep going. Yeah, they solved one of those puzzles. Oh, Draugr. Ooh. Pavel, don't mess around with no Draugr. Leveled up. We're gonna save that level up though for when we start getting low on health. Alright, two weapon fighting is the way to do. Lydia? Oh. We have to go let our friends in. Doop a doop a doo. Just gotta go hit this lever. Mistakes were made. But we survived. Actually, maybe gonna upgrade our weapons a bit here. Ancient Nord War Axe is better. Steel Club is better too. So. put those on our hotkeys. We're going to say main hand war axe, off hand club, save. Save our actual game too. So we're not picky about what weapons we're going to use. Pavel, I think, is a utilitarian sort of guy. Like, he's going to pick up anything he can. I'm going to hit this lever. Oh, okay. Just want to make sure that that doesn't drop me into the ground. Pavel's a utilitarian. Like, you know, well, he's not a philosophical utilitarian, probably. Right, I used a loot magnet spell down below, and it looted this guy up here. What's up, punks? Meet my new weapons? Ooh, yeah. That's a trap. There's no way that's not a trap. Ooh. Adept? Eh. Alright, there we go. Trapper, no. We're getting that lead. That one is also some kind of monster. Just checking our spells here, trying to clear up some weight. Yeah, 100% a monster. And it's this one and this. Yeah. You can solve puzzles or you can just memorize them. Our divine armor leveled up. Let's go to Forgotten Magic. Oh, wait, two levels that we haven't spent. So what does it do so far? It makes us take less spell damage. It increases our armor rating, and it discounts our spells. So let's go with Redemption and Devote Deflection. So now when we get hit, it's going to return damage to our attackers, and this is good because it's going to help us out against dragons. Because let me tell you, dragons are a problem. Dragons are perhaps the problem. Giants, we already fought a giant. I mean, we fought a dragon too, but... dragons are going to get harder. Giants are going to stay the same. So let's take a look around here. We've got the markers, which is snake, whale, eagle. Axe in the face. Let's grab their inventory. See if we got anything good. Not really. We're still too low level to get a lot of like decent loot. So it's eagle, whale, snake. Dragons are easy with the right magic. And we're definitely going to fight some dragons with magic too. But for right now, especially as Pavel, who has no ranged attacks and only two weapons. So it was eagle. Whale, snake. And then we'll go check this room back here. Grab all these soul gems, which we're going to need sometime in the future. Aha! Yeah, later we might bust out Helen, and Helen's a magic user. There we are. Take that, spider. Now we've got another claw door. This is, I believe, our second. Ooh, damn. Guys, as they come out of their coffins. Bam! Oh, too far away. Oh no. Yeah, I love Loot Magnet. Makes my life so just so much of a less of a pain in the butt. Now let's go and see how many iron shields we have. Yeah, 6. Any new spells? Lightning Strike. Lightning Strike is going to help out our Thunder God. Alright, so with Ivory Claw, there's Eagle, Heron. Eagle. Oh, it's not a heron, it's a dragon. I always read that as a heron. I guess dragon makes a lot more sense. We're gonna need this ivory claw later too, so we better hold on. Bolgunthor Crypt. I don't remember which one this is. Every brother has a different fighting style. Oh, this is the melee brother. This is Mikhail. What's up, punk? I came here to wreck your party. To completely wreck your ships. He isn't even now he's summoning the ads, yeah. Kill him, they all die. So now we get the Galdur Amulet Fragment. So this is going to bump our health by 30 points. And we also get the Black Blade, which is a health absorbing sword. That is the sound of all his other adds dying. This thing used to be like impossible because I had another mod that put a bunch of weapons up these stairs. I'm pretty sure I got rid of it, but there was a dragon priest over here and it would just annihilate you. Oh, we also had a word wall. Frost Breath. Nice. What do we got for gear? Barbarian Gauntlets, Steel Mace, some potions, shield, Iron Gauntlets of Archery, and Scroll of Mirror Entity. Control an illusion of target humanoid for 20 seconds. In combat, it will attack opponents in range. The caster cannot act, but can cast spells. Sheath to cancel. Oh, neat. And we'll pull out the Steel Greatsword. Head out of Fulgunthor. Back to real life. I don't remember if it was Skyrim or... Oh! Stepped into the trap again. I don't remember if it was Skyrim or Kingdoms of Amalur that introduced me to the notion of the circular dungeon. But I love it. I don't care how cheesy it is that there's always like a gateway to the entrance at the back of every dungeon. Does not matter to me. Gameplay-wise, it makes my life so easy and so good that I don't care how silly it is. So we've got this Galdor amulet quest now. Forbidden Legend. I have to read his notes. Danis Valen's notes. Archmage Galdor was revered. Please, game, stop covering up the text. Even Ysgrimmor's heirs sought his counsel. We'll maybe learn about Ysgrimmor later tonight. Galdor's three sons were cruel and resentful. They wanted his power, his prestige, and they divided and stole his amulet. Until Geirmund, the Archmage, destroyed them. The amulet survives. It is powerful.
I'm nowhere to ruin.
Nifty question about circular dungeons in D&D. The answer is no. You'll never see circular dungeons in D&D because time in D&D is relative. It stretches and moves. So if you're worried about time in D&D, you don't have to. Let's go home for a moment. Yeah, Halam Shural, that's where that dragon is. So Sarthal, which we can't get into. And Gehrman's Hall, which we can. First, we're going to save. And then we're going to go home. But no, time in D&D is stretchy. It stretches with the narrative. You're like, well, we leave the dungeon. And the GM's like, well, there's no danger, so okay, you leave the dungeon. But if you played Morrowind, you know that sometimes you, like, the challenge is finding your way out of the dungeon after you've already completed the objective and you're just lost. And being lost in games is not super fun, often. Alright, so we're at home. And we're just gonna hop into our basement and make some throwing knives. I raved about this house on the first episode, and I stand by it. This is my favorite house in the world. And you can see if I step through here, we've got Janet's gear, and during bonus stream we'll lay out everybody else's that we already have. Also make them new gear. We might do that tonight. It's kind of a chill night. I'm looking to relax. Partly because I've been working a ton on Maker Expo stuff. So, let's use the Skyforge. It's here in the basement. And let's make some iron throwing knives. I never played Daggerfall. Morrowind was my first Elder Scrolls game, so I don't know too much about Daggerfall, but I can believe that it's worse. Okay, so we're gonna put back our materials, and we're gonna try and remember how throwing knives work. So I'm gonna put them on a hotkey. I've got my throwing knives, I'm just gonna chuck one. Cool. Throwing knives. Can we pick them back up? No. But they do stick in the wall. But circular dungeons are awful. Or non-circular dungeons are awful. Depends on the game, depends on the philosophy, depends on the purpose. Like, context is relevant, but I remember in Kingdoms of Amalur where I was just, it was so great. Amalur was a really good time anyway, though. It was like Skyrim, only I want to say more, a little more cinematic, a little more high fantasy. Because just because of the art style. Alright, so let's do another dungeon. We're going to go to Gehrman's Hall, and then we're probably going to take a break. Gehrman's Hall is probably going to take us a little bit. And then I think we'll come back and we'll do some bonus streamy type stuff, rather than busting out a warlock and doing that. So that'll be a good time. So now we're in Iverstead. Let's check our supplies. You're hungry and thirsty. So let's drink some boiled water. And eat a carrot and some bread. And this apple. Just sort of chill out.
You would have made an excellent addition to our company.
Where are my horse?
Nine doesn't quite have the same ring to it. If
all right. I missed the context. What was less open world than Skyrim, but a really good game? Almalur? Yeah. It was you had a purpose in Almalur, and it was clear. Like, you had a main quest, and areas progressed. It was a lot like single-player World of Warcraft, which is, my understanding, what everyone is watching tonight now that Legion dropped. But that's okay. I refuse to go back to WoW. Not for any, like, particular moral reason, but just because I don't think I'd really enjoy it anymore. And with Pavel, Pavel can actually defend himself with throwing knives while smashing things with his club. Which is going to be super useful. Ooh! It's a humdinger right there. Remember all the stuff I said about we really don't want to get wet because we'll die? Well, here we go. Let's take a look down here. No, people. I need you to stay where you are so I can breathe. Hello. All right. So now we're starting to get into our next snake puzzle, which is eagle, whale, whale, snake. So, eagle. Actually, you're just gonna chuck throwing knives at people. Oh, and we can pick our throwing knives up off of bodies. Super useful. Eagle, whale, whale, snake. So that needs to be whale. Needs to be snake. Right? Eagle, whale, whale, snake. Hit the lever. Yeah! Throwing knives. Lydia, can you take my things? Thank you. Oh, we should switch this Galder Blackblade into the mix, maybe. Yeah, let's do that. Let's try to take off the club. And we'll put on the steel mace. And the Blackblade. And we got a new ring as well, the Band of Permanence. Main hand, off hand, save. And now is when we need those. Very nice. Also racking up those archery points. Gehrman's Epitaph. Lord Gehrman, Archmage of Windhelm. Battle mage to King Harold. Magus, keep thy vigil eternal. Serve now in death as you did in life. By these seals our realm preserve from traitors three and their charm of strife. Legit. Archmage Gearman, eh? Steel longsword. Scroll of wizard fire. 400 points of magic damage, but it can kill you. I love it. Spider. Grab that axe. Skyrim, the first person shooter. Yeah, we've been pretty much operating in third person. I only really go into first for ranged attacks. But it seems like this is a pretty good map for ranged attacks. I don't want to hit this. Those spikes are in the wall. I want to hit this one. Boom! Yeah, I know what I'm doing. I'm good at this game. Hop! Hop! There's a knife in your head. Ooh! Lydia, sorry about that. It's right in the back. What? Oh, jeez. Right in the base of the skull. Alright. Oh no, we have a thing for this. We don't even need to. Right. Technically, Pavel doesn't use shouts. Although, actually, that's not true. Technically, Pavel doesn't use shouts as a ranged attack. So I think Whirlwind Sprint is a perfectly legit shout for Pavel. So I'm going to put it on his hotkey. Oh, that's not throwing knife. That's an embalming tool. That's useless. Okay, here we are. Now we're in the real deal. I'm going to hop down here. He's gonna teleport away. He's gonna reappear in three spots. And so what you gotta do is figure out which one the real him is. Ooh. Okay. In the meantime, he's gonna like yell at me. Shoot arrows, whatever else. So we're just gonna throw knives at him. Chucking knives. Engaging this guy in melee is super bad. He's got a disarming shout, so he'll shove you back. So. Chuck knives. Because this is what Pavel. Damn it! We would have had him! Excuse me. Alright. Knives are in this man. 26 knives. Oh my god. Well, we got there. 26 knives to kill an ancient zombie man. So let's read the writ of sealing here. That's our second one. Let's also see if we got any new spells. Doesn't look like it. Bound here, Sigdis, murderer, betrayer, condemned by your crimes against realm and lord. May your name and your deeds be forgotten forever, and the charm which you bear be sealed by our ward. Cute. And the other one, of course, was Mikril. Same rhyme, different name. All right, I can deal with that. I believe we need to talk to Lydia briefly. On account of the whole I can't move. And now we have the black bow. We've also got I'm accumulating barbarian armor. The second fragment. So this one increases stamina by 30 points. Actually, we're going to get the health one on because... Right. We're going to equip that. There we go. So... stamina. Health. Now, the last one, of course, is magic. But the last one is also sealed away in Sarthal, and I'll need a special quest to go in there, which I do not have. Come on, give me the skull! Skulls are part of some crafting recipes that I want to use later. So, I'm all about the skulls. Get some stuff, get some pearls, apparently pick up that plate because it's how Skyrim works. Open that up, and circular dungeon, the best kind. Head out into the light. Now we're going to say goodbye to Pavel here. And, Oh, it's wolves. I'll tear you to pieces. I thought it was something serious. We're going to say goodbye to Pavel. We're going to take a break. I'll be back in about 10 minutes, so about, let's say 8:15. And we're going to hang out for a while. We might end the stream early so that I can get some other work done. But we'll be going for at least another hour. Ooh, useful.